Say hello to the first ever look of the Doomsday Device 2.0. Today's new Fortnite trailer secretly revealing the entire live event, brand new Marvel skins, brand new insane Season 3 items coming to the game. Let's talk about it now. Zapatron is going to be coming to Fortnite, possibly in Season 3. If you watch closely in the first 5 seconds, what is this? We have Dr. Sloan herself holding the mythic Zapatron that has not been in game since 2017. The Zapatron is coming back to the game. There's also a brand new skin fully leaked, which fully explains this NPC quote. Tell me again about your friend, the pink synthesoid. This is fully relating to the Marvel Vision skin. And coincidentally, who do we see in the back of this image? None other than Vision himself standing in the back. We're getting a Vision skin, boys! All those new items sound crazy, but what if I told you the return of Clombo will be a lot more different and shocking than you think? And somehow this all relates to the Doomsday device that we will be showing later in the video. All I can say is say goodbye to the Fortnite map. There are rumors everywhere that Clombo is inside of the IO vault, and here's a video itself of someone breaking inside of the vault and Clombo was inside. We don't know if this is real, we don't know if this is fake, but this is the return of Clombo. Let's take a look at this trailer. We have the vault itself opening up very slowly with the vault sound that is so sick, and inside of the vault we are about to say hello to our old friend Clombo. Oh, come on. There he is. There he is! Oh my gosh, and this, I assume, would be the Clombo Paradise POI that hopefully will come to the game. This looks absolutely amazing. Imagine if they add this to the game, and this is a real trailer. It is confirmed that Clombos are finally going to be making a return. But Clombo is going to be a little bit different thanks to this leak. Epic is working on making Clombos being able to be eliminated. As of right now, they're working on making them drop a special version of meat. 15 different types of loot, including ammo, mats, consumables, and maybe weapons. That's why they added that NPC meat item yesterday. That's really good news that Clombo is returning. But with every piece of good news also comes with bad news. This is all leading up to the destruction of Tilted Towers, which might be happening sooner than you think. Remember, once Clombo gets eliminated for the first time, we're going to be saying goodbye to Tilted Towers forever. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, check this out. This is from when Clombos first came to the game. We've only had Clombos for a day, but if anything ever happened to them, we would eliminate all of Tilted. Clombos are gone, yes, but nothing actually happened to them yet. That is, until they come back and we're able to eliminate them. That's right, very soon we are going to be saying goodbye forever to Tilted Towers. It was nice knowing you, Tilted. But Fortnite can't keep us upset forever, which is why we're saying hello to Miles Morales and the return of the web shooters to the game. And don't forget, stick around to see the Doomsday Device 2.0. Please, if you're watching this and you're enjoying this so far, subscribe and help me reach 5 million subscribers. And comment down below if the Doomsday Device returns. Are you on Team IO or Team 7? Me personally, I'm on Team 7. This is not a joke. It's coming faster than you think. Spider-Man's Mythic was updated yesterday. They're reworking the camera movement, and they will most likely return somehow at some point. Fortnite usually never removes a Mythic item from the game and then randomly brings it back in the exact same way, so somehow they're going to be changing this item. People everywhere are predicting that the Miles Morales variant of the Spider-Man web shooters is coming very soon to the game. With that being said, say hello to the Miles Morales trailer in Fortnite. If this skin ever comes out, which it will very soon, here's a fan-made trailer of what it would look like, and look how sick this is. I want the Miles skin so badly. Subscribe if you want it as well. We have Prowler fighting Miles Morales. Boom, right in the head. That looks so amazing. Miles Morales available now. Comment down below if you would love to see the Miles skin in the game. A new Spider-Man based outfit will be included as a code in the first Fortnite Marvel comic. Could this be where we finally get the Miles Morales skin? I would be so happy. What people won't be happy about is the Doomsday Device 2.0. That's right. We'll be showing that shortly, but first we need to show you the Peter Griffin skin. Here's a screenshot from an Epic Games developer, and apparently they leaked Peter Griffin. Here are some files, and then if you go to the right, there is a folder in the Fortnite files called Family Guy. And before we show actual gameplay of it, I was just sent this by an insider. You can see there's Jonesy, there's Darth Vader, and there is Peter Griffin flying out of a helicopter, and it literally looks like a Fortnite skin. And going to the next image, it looks like Peter Griffin himself in the item shop. And on top of that, enjoy some gameplay of what this would actually look like to have a Peter Griffin skin in Fortnite. Yes, this is custom made. speed, but you can see how absolutely cursed this looks. Peter Griffin using custom guns, a diamond sword. Comment down below, would you love to see a Peter Griffin skin in Fortnite? Honestly, I have mixed opinions about it. But we won't be able to use this skin at all if the Doomsday Device 2.0 destroys the entire island. Fortnite has been very silent about the upcoming live events until about yesterday. We are learning a lot of information about the Doomsday Device 2.0, and it's shaping out to be even worse than the last one, and this one might end up in a success. According to Jonesy's challenges, he asks you to put recon cameras near Loot Lake to get more information about the IO's Doomsday Device. And in that last territory's map stage, we can see that the IO gets to keep Loot Lake. We could get an event there. Before we show an exclusive look of the Doomsday Device 2.0, back in Fortnite Chapter 2, we saw a picture on the wall showing Sloan as a child. On the left-hand side, you could see Midas. We thought that it had no meaning, which means he's been working for the IO longer than we thought, but now this is where things get crazier. Apparently, there is now a Midas NPC on the Chapter 3 map at the crashed blimp. Go to the Midas NPC, bring him over with a fishing rod. Where is he going? The NPC is now walking by himself, then he will pull out a clock. Does this mean the agency is returning because it has the flags from the 7? Let's try this out right now. I've been getting so many comments saying that this is real. There is the ship itself. Let's test this out so you don't have to. Imagine if Fortnite actually added a Midas NPC that goes to the Daily Bugle. Let's drop down and let's see if this is a myth or if this is real. Comment down below, real or cap. All right, dropping down to the blimp itself. I'm not seeing anything yet. No, that myth is definitely busted. Time to show you guys the Doomsday Device 2.0. This is the first ever look of the Doomsday Device 2.0. New location, Doomsday 2.0. We have the Spider-Man skin looking at it. The device looks very activated. And you can see on the bottom right-hand corner are Chapter 3 items. Do you think this leak is real? Do you think this is the first real image of the next upcoming live event? Comment down below and let me know. Now that Midas is going to be teaming up with the IO for a Doomsday Device, comment down below. Do you think we're going to win again? Or do you think the island is in big trouble? Bye!